Hello there, it's the Archivist from TradingCardArchives.com, and it's another Saturday morning, which means it's time for Cards and Coffee. And I know I was planning to do a couple of big battles, but I got a little lazy this morning and decided instead I'm just going to rip a box. So this morning's Cards and Coffee is going to be Operation Unbox-Zaku, and we're going to pick one of these boxes and unbox the entire thing. As you know, I love these Gundam cards. I collect them in my personal collection, and I'm trying to complete the set, so I have quite a few boxes. These three are nice sealed boxes that have never been opened before, so I figured we could crack one today. This one's a little damaged, but you know, sometimes there's something called damaged box mojo, so that might be the one with the most hits in it. You never know. But it is Cards and Coffee, so if you have your own coffee, give it a drink. I'm gonna drink mine. It helps me go a little bit faster, maybe. I don't know, I'm usually pretty slow with these, but we'll see how we can do here. So first thing we gotta do is pick which one to open. So there's three boxes here, 1, 2, and 3. I've got random.org set up to roll a dice from 1 to 3, and we're gonna roll that 3 times and take the third result. So here we go. First roll is a 1. Second roll, 2. Third roll, also 2. So 2 is the box we're going to open today. We don't need random.org anymore because we're going to open the entire box. Before we dig into that, though, I want to show you my top cards for the day. We're just getting started for the weekend, so we really only have a couple boxes have been opened so far. If you didn't see the video opening of the Spider-Man set, definitely go watch it. This set is incredible. Such a good set of cards. Amazing. It's breathtaking to look at this thing still today. This is the PR box promo card that came with that set, the one I got at least. And I really like it. Looks great. So that's my top card. And my second place card came from the new Star Wars flagship set. So this set just came out yesterday. It's Topps Flagship 2023, and this is a hologram card, which is short print, but not numbered. So it's not a numbered card at all, but it is very rare. In fact, more rare than some of the numbered cards. I pulled a numbered to 299 from the same box. I pulled this card, which is to 299. This is more rare. This is at about a 1 in 32 pack rarity. This is at a 1 in 132 pack rarity. So this is the more rare card. And also, I love lenticular cards, and this one seems to be really well done. So definitely my second place card there. Only reason that one's first is it looks a lot better. But hopefully we can find something even better in this box. So this is Little Frog's Gundam Mechanical Story set, and it is, I think, the best Gundam card set out right now, and maybe in a long time. There hasn't really been a good Gundam set for a while. The Wafer Gunpla set was really good, but I don't collect those Wafer cards because you get so many of those stupid cookies, and they don't taste very good, so I don't like collecting those. I only have a couple of those, but I do love regular trading cards, and this set is kind of unique in that it is by Little Frog, who usually makes bootleg cards or waifu cards, like Goddess Story cards. They're kind of the primary manufacturer of all the Goddess Story cards, but they made this set of Gundam about a year ago. And it is awesome. I mean, it is a really, really, really good set. I have one of these ZR cards. I have the Unicorn Destroy Mode one. And it's awesome. It has like a fake signature of Amuro, the pilot, on it. It's great. It's a super good card. But you don't get many hits in the boxes. The last box I broke only had, I think, 3 URs. And that was it. There was nothing higher than UR in there. And I was a little bit sad, but maybe this box will be kinder to us. Let's see. So I'll go ahead and put that over there. And we'll just get going here, because we need to open all of these today, like I said. And I do need to sleeve them as well, so it's going to be Going to be a bit of a video here, but we'll get through it. The benefit is I have a lot of these already, so we don't need to spend hours on each card or anything like that. I'll just mention maybe some of the features as we go here, but really I'm looking for ones I don't have yet. This SR level is the base level in the set, so you're going to get mostly SR cards. You're going to get four cards in a pack. Three will be SR most of the time, and then one will be a hit of some type. And then your last card will be one of these redemption cards. And you're going to get a lot of redemption cards. You'll get one in each pack. And the SR rarity cards actually have custom foil treatments on them. Like you see, this one has star refraction in the background. This one has more of a kind of maze-like refraction. I really like this card. Looks so good. ARC 78 NT1. I think I have this one already, but I'm not sure. I love the colors on it though. It looks great. This is another SR. And what's cool is when the Gundams have a designated pilot, the pilot is on the card. So like the AMS-129 is a kind of mass-produced suit. Many people have piloted that suit, and usually it's like a red shirt type thing where this one is the first to go. So it doesn't have a pilot designated, but these other ones have designated pilots that flew these models, so they become... Look at the foil on that, the way it changes from red to blue. Amazing. And then another Psycho-Zaku. Okay, so the SR that I got today is a Psycho-Zaku. I already have, two of these? I think two of those. It's a great... A model, awesome Gundam, like really, really cool looking Gundam. I have the Gunpla model of that right over there, in fact. And it's huge. It's over a foot long because this giant backpack has huge rockets on the back of it. They call it like Psycho-Zaku mobility because all the extra rockets help it move around in space. It's kind of a... One second. Sorry. So what I really love about this show, the Gundam franchise generally, is they are very good about sort of what it would be like to actually have one of these in space. Because if you think about it, air resistance doesn't matter, right? So it wouldn't have to look all sleek. It can be all spindly with all these little parts sticking out of it and still go through space just fine, as long as it has a lot of fuel. And so what that Psycho-Zaku suit is primarily a huge fuel tank on the back. And that's why it's called mobility, because it can burn that fuel to go faster than any other mobile suit could. Unfortunately, it was going up against Gundams, which are kind of like super-powered and can definitely beat that. It didn't win usually, but it didn't win at all. But it's still a very cool-looking suit. Another rare here. So I love when they're like shooting their rocket. They have just rockets everywhere. When you build the model kits, the primary thing you're doing is attaching rockets to things like feet, elbows, knees. Every part of the Gundam has some kind of rocket on it. A lot of dupes here today. Maybe like that is the only one I don't have yet. This is interesting. I don't think I have this SSR yet. Maybe. No, I do. I do. I have that one. Never mind. So my two hits have been SSRs so far. I'm really looking for higher hits than that, because there are lots of other rarities. There's UR, which we rarely ever see. And then there's, you know, the ZR signature cards, too, which I would love to pull another one of those. But it has not happened yet. And remember, keep drinking your coffee. Mm-hmm. One of those. Always I get five. I wish I could get a higher than five. Oh, that's new. I don't have this one yet. That's cool. Although, again, it's one of those mass-produced mobile suits, so it doesn't have a designated pilot, but still, that looks pretty cool. I'll put that right over there. This is AMS-108. I just love the foil on these. Honestly, this set convinced me that Little Frog is like a decently good designer, and I kind of trust them now. And if you've watched any of my recent like package openings, I've been ordering a lot of stuff that they made that is a bit obscure, mostly because everything they make seems to be awesome. So, like, even the really obscure sets I'm getting from them have amazing cards in them. So, they're kind of like one of my go-to manufacturers now, where, besides the Goddess Story stuff, just because I don't want to get too deep into that, so I don't buy those. But pretty much anything else Little Frog makes, I will go ahead and buy. And I'm slowly acquiring all the stuff they used to make. So, for example, they make like One Piece cards and League of Legends cards I'm gonna get soon. Those are bootlegs, like 100% bootlegs, but still should be pretty awesome from what I've seen. And like the main thing I really like about them as a manufacturer is they put treatments on even their most basic cards. So even their base cards have great treatments, like great custom. This one I don't think I have, and that has just awesome custom foil work on it. I mean, it just looks great, right? Oh, I don't think I have this either. FA, yeah, that's a full armor 78. Awesome. The FA means full armor. I don't think that actually has its full armor. Oh, actually, yeah, it does. It has these little extra pieces. That's what they mean. And it looks like we're getting another SR, which is the Z Gundam. Full armor Z Gundam specifically. Already have that. So yeah, I have all four of those already, which kind of a little bit sad. But like I said, the boxes are rough. I keep thinking I'm gonna try and complete this, and I want to, but the pull rates from these boxes is just so rough that I'm not sure I'll ever get there. Oh, I got a 10. Nice. I keep trying, and I have many, many of these, and they're cheap. They're like $16 a box. But if you only are gonna get one or two hits in an entire box, it's very unlikely I'll ever complete this set. But I should at least be able to complete the SR level. And that's pretty amazing on its own. There's so many SR cards. There's over 60 of them in the set. And they cover, I think, every, like, I can't think of a single Mobile Suit Gundam type thing that isn't in there. Even Gun Tank is in there. Ball Gundam's there. So that's one of the. That's an SSR? Yeah, that's an SSR. So we haven't gotten a UR yet. And again, this is one I already have, so not that impressed yet. Let me move these down here. So I've got a little bit of a glare area here again. Trying to like always work on my lighting, and I think it looks pretty good now, but there's glare still, as you can see. You got some glare here too. Maybe put that down there a little better. Okay. I was hoping that because that had a 10 redemption in it, I thought maybe that meant it would be a bigger hit in that pack, but it wasn't. It was just a UR again. Or an SSR, even, not a UR. It's another. See that really cool hexagon pattern in the background and just the way the colors shift? It's awesome. This would be like a. The way Kaio would. This would be like a UR in Kaio land. And it's just an SSR here. Love this one with the feathers. I already have it, but I love the one with the feathers on it. Good looking one here. Mass 099. Not a mass produced suit though. It doesn't have a designated pilot, whereas this does. This is Sazabi. So Sazabi is one of the, well, Char's personal Zaku that he flies in Char's counterattack. And it's an awesome mobile suit. It's huge. Like, it's so much bigger than any of the other Gundams. Like, it's twice the size of that thing and that thing, but it's about the same size as that one. But he still didn't win. But it's a very powerful machine, and the model kits for it are awesome. The RG version of that model is probably one of the best model kits Bandai ever created. It's just so much fun to build. It's very articulate. It holds position really well. And I used to do a lot of Gunpla modeling before this. That was my old hobby. But those take up way too much space, so I had to stop doing that. Actually, I had like a backlog of maybe 30 of these Gunpla models that I didn't even get to building yet. I don't know if you can tell that I tend to overbuy on things. Oh, really? That's kind of a weird surprise. But yeah, I do. And so I ended up having like so many of them. And I just sold them all off to a reseller. I was like, you can sell these all on eBay and get more money for them if you want, but I want out of this hobby. That's a nice SSR. I don't think I have that one yet. Looks great. Think I might have it. I don't think I've gotten a single new card here yet today. We'll get there. We got a few packs left to go here. My goal is to end this at 30 minutes if I can. And then the rest of the day, the plan is kind of to get through a lot of different Star Wars products because I want to prep to do a big Star Wars battle tomorrow. But I realize like a lot of the Star Wars stuff I have has never been opened yet. And that's a little bit of a problem because I don't know, I don't want to open it all in the battle video because that will then also take a long time. So I kind of want to do a couple of videos today where I just get a bunch of the product opened and look at a bit of it, and then tomorrow I can put it all on the table together and do like a giant battle. Love the foil treatment on that one. That is gorgeous. Sorry, I love these cards, as you can tell. Striking out though on the hits here. What are we, 10 packs in? 8 packs in? 8 packs in, and we haven't really gotten a major hit yet. Just SSRs. This is one I don't have yet, which is nice. I actually don't know very much about this particular Gundam. It is MO1. And it looks like it has some kind of like sheets of cloth or something. That's weird. I don't know much about that Gundam. It also has like these little horns on it. Like a weird mustache thing. I don't know what that is. What is that from? Hey, I'm gonna pause and go look up what this is from. I'm very curious. This one looks interesting. One second. Okay, so this is like Turn A Gundam's title Gundam. I guess I've never watched Turn A, but this is the main Gundam in that. Pretty cool. I couldn't figure out what that sheet attack was, though. The wiki doesn't explain that one, or at least I couldn't understand it. But yeah, that's pretty cool. It's rare I see one I just had never even heard of, so usually I can recognize them even if I don't know their names or where they're from. But if I can't even recognize them, I'm always a little bit surprised. But yeah, okay, that one I definitely know. That weird, like, triangle looking face. Ooh, that's an ASTRAE. I love the foil treatment on that. Looks so good. So yeah, like I said, I mean, this is, I think, one of the best Gundam sets probably ever made, or very close to it. I mean, I know the Gundam dual sets are also really good. Like, I have those too, but they aren't as value as this, right? You only get, you know, two cards in a pack, and or maybe three cards in a pack. And they're really expensive and quite limited, like Cubelet. Whereas this is, you know, more value-oriented set, right? You can open a lot of packs, get a lot of cards, and plus it has more variety of Gundams. Like, I don't know why, but the Gundam dual set will have the same like PM01 Gundam like three different times in the SSR level. And I'm like, come on, there's 50 years of Gundam material to pull from. You don't need to reuse the same one three times. Whereas here it's just a variety of things. You even get, you know, the weird mobile weapon platforms that aren't, that don't even count as condoms. Super cool looking card here. Oh, another awesome one. The little swirls in the background on that. Super nice. One of the problems with the number of these that I have, though, is when I finish this video, I'm gonna have to go and figure out like which ones I are dupes and which ones aren't. That takes a little time. But I, you know, this web, the website has scans of every single card I've opened, so I can kind of go in there and search. Another SSR. Now that's an awesome looking SSR. That's one of those. That's like Red Astray, right? With the sword. I think that's what that is. Those are also really fun models to build. The Gundam is so articulate this kind. You can pose them like they can do the splits, all kinds of weird stuff. That's a good looking card. Still, we've only gotten SSRs out of this entire box so far. I'm a little bit disappointed. Not even one UR yet? I mean, come on. Give me something. I don't think it's really possible to search these boxes, and I don't think there's any secondary market for this set. That's not true. There's like a little bit of a secondary market, but nothing like, there's no $100 cards in here, that's for sure. You know, like the most I've seen these sell for is like a couple dollars for one, so I don't see why anyone would search and steal. It doesn't make any sense. That's definitely a dupe because we just pulled that one. Still looking really good. Oh, it's like a duplicate pack almost. A lot of dupes in there. Gonna need more sleeves. Makes sense. We are opening 100 cards right now, so we will need 100 sleeves in order to do that. And I just ran out. Don't worry. I'm gonna have to buy even more. I'm considering getting a case from Cardboard Gold. So Cardboard Gold is a long-term like manufacturer of top loaders and sleeves and all kinds of stuff like that. And they sell a case of sleeves, 10,000 for like $70. And I know I'll use that many. It's just I have trouble. I haven't been able to convince myself to put a $70 order in for sleeves yet. But like I said, I will almost certainly use them all. And I definitely would use them all. It's another 10. But again, we didn't get even a UR. This is just an SSR again. Although that is a fantastic looking card. Wow. Really good looking card here. And put next to that one. So nice. And these are just SSRs, second level rarities, right? There's URs above this, there's CP, there's many, many other rarities that I never seem to pull. I know they're in there because I have gotten them once, but it's like one in an entire box. Not a great pull rate, I would say. You know, so if you're getting this casually, probably buy one or two boxes max. Because after that, you're just going to be swimming in dupes that you won't know what to do with, and you're really just not going to get a lot of big hits. Only if you're really committed to collecting this would I get more than two boxes. I think I've gotten six total boxes so far. But I'm pretty committed. Finally, something different. Okay, what is this? I've never seen this before. So this is an SD rarity. Oh, SD Gundam. I get it. Okay, so the SD Gundams are super deformed. That's what that SD means. And they're chibi Gundams, basically. So this is a Cubelet chibi. How cute. We have the regular Cubelet here too. So here's Cubelet, not chibi, Cubelet chibi. Similar coloring, but different card. I've never seen a horizontal card before either. That's excellent. Finally, we're getting something out of this. Let me move that and kind of put that right there because that's super cool. I guess it's in the shadow. Maybe I can take the box down. Get this box out. There's nothing in it. Keep things out of the glare. All right. I don't know. We're gonna make 30 minutes. We're at 25 minutes right now. It looks like I maybe have 7 or 8 packs left open. But we should get close. Oh, what is that? Giratoga? Oh, I don't remember what they call this one. It's not the one with the whip, but it's. That's a really good looking card. See the cities? There's like a destroyed city behind it. Really cool looking. Yeah, another one. Nice. And then what do we got here? Anything other than an SSR, please? No, just another SSR. Oh, it's one I don't have for sure now. There's so many rockets on that. Oh, it's a mobile weapons platform. Because look, that's the Gundam right there. It's so small. That thing is like a huge space station kind of deal. Looks great. It's an awesome. That's awesome. I really like that one because it's like one of those huge mobile weapons platforms. Drink some more coffee. There's a couple of those in the Gundam universe. Some of them can move around and are like pilotable. And they're huge. Here. Let's turn my sound down quick. Another SR GN07. Can I say 05? Oh, this is the O, right? I think so, with that giant like triangle behind his head. This is my I have a couple copies of this one now, but it's easily my favorite of all of them. Like just the colors and the way the refraction works on this. It's easily my favorite card. I love this card. Oh, we got another something here. Oh, this is just an SSR. It just looks really cool. Oh, it's a GP01, GP02A, sorry. So this is like nuclear Gundam, I guess they call it. It's got a giant, like, nuclear bazooka thing that it uses to shoot. And this huge shield, too, like just massive, massive active shield on the front. Really cool looking model kit for that. It's neat. Although Bandai hasn't made many model kits of that. I think they only very recently made one. But there are third-party model kits of that, which are amazing. Like, there's one Mechanicor makes that is just great. I'm sure I've talked about it before, because I had it. I couldn't actually build it, because it takes a lot of modeling skill to build a Mechanicor kit. Because the kits are very poorly molded. And so you end up having to, like, glue and pin and file basically every single part you cut. And then there's thousands of parts. But really the problem that I had with it was the electronics. Because those kits come with tons of lights, like maybe 50 different little LED lights all over it. And they all need to be wired into the kit itself. And nothing was fitting for me, and I just couldn't get it to work. And I ended up giving up near the end, but and selling it all. There's another nice SSR. RX-93. These, like, fin things on the back can launch and be sort of like independent drones that it can control. Another model kit. The model kit for this is also really fun. The RG is probably my favorite again. Looks like we're down to the last five packs. Still, that is the highest rarity thing we've pulled. And if it's like other boxes, that might be all we see. Like, that might be the only hit in this entire box, which is rough. But if you love Gundam, it's not that big a deal because you love looking at them anyway. Yeah, so I'm never going to complain about having a huge pile of Gundam cards. That one's awesome, especially these ones. Little Frog, very good designer. They make the Fire Legend Multiverse anime set, which is also really, really good. Very well done set. So yeah, definitely. I mean, it's kind of unfortunate that they mostly work in bootleg product, but they make some good bootleg product. Well, that's the first 20 I've ever seen. I've never gotten a 20 before. Those are like redemption points for some kind of point system. Look at how the stars move on that. It's just SSR, right? This isn't even a UR. A lot of good SSRs, but no URs at all yet. No ZR. I would love to have another ZR. There's like these battle level cards that where you put two together and it makes a like a battle. I can't imagine ever getting two of them given the pull rates here. But even just getting one, I'd be pretty happy with. This one is cool. Like, look, it's like in the jungle and it's got moss growing all over it. Very cool piece of artwork on this card. Jin. RGM 79s are called Jin sometimes, and they're a very commodity suit. You'll see Grunts wearing that suit a lot. That's cool. And just SSR, but very cool looking card. Almost done here. Oh, that was not a clean cut at all. We go. Sometimes the pilots are the funniest looking things. Ooh, that's pretty nice. Sorry, I'm having trouble with my sleeve direction again. What? Maybe it's broken? Oh, there it goes. So now we have just a pile of Gundam cards. I think there's all organization has gone out the window. But that's okay. Oh, finally a UR. Okay, great. So this is a little bit more of a hit. And you can see the treatments are dialed up even higher on this. And they also show the logo of the show, usually, the show they're from. Oh man, that got severely damaged on the back though. That sucks. I mean, the front looks good, but man, the back of that thing is rough. I will just never show the back of this card. Put that right there, actually. That's cool. Two more packs. And I don't think I'll do a full recap of this video. But I probably will do like a showcase of those and just post that as a short. Yeah, but I hope, I'll open some more of these at some point, and I Hope I convinced some of you to get them, because they are a great set, and I would love to see a secondary market appear. I guess I'd probably be pretty dominant in that market, but I can't be the only person. Like, this is a mass-produced thing. There has to be more people collecting this than just me. Nice. Okay, last pack, and we've gotten two hits in the entire box. Which, I know that seems real stingy, but that is what I've experienced so far. I opened, I guess, three of these boxes now, and it's been like that in each one, where you're just barely pulling hits, and the hits you pull are small hits. That's, like, it's weird, because the very, very, very first pack I ever opened had a ZR, a top rarity card in it, but other than that, I've never really pulled anything above UR. I think this SD is below UR, in fact. And it doesn't look like we're going to get anything crazy here, just another SSR, but that's okay. Maybe in one of the other boxes we'll have better luck for me. Do you see how difficult it would be? Because there's, you know, 20-some different URs to collect. Which means you're buying 20 boxes, because you're not going to get many. Well, there's Grandpa himself, RX-78-2. That looks kind of cool, right? I like it. That's a good card to end on. Grandpa's a great Gundam. He's the, you know, the very original Gundam. Great card to end on. All right, there is a box of Gundam Mechanical Story. Whole entire box here opened for you, and I hope you enjoyed the video. I will try to sort through these a little bit and then make a showcase, but that's probably it for this. And then I'm going to move on, like I said, to Star Wars stuff the rest of the day. But yeah, I'll cut this video here now. We're at 37 minutes, which is long, but not my longest video. All right, I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.